Welcome to the coffee shop, everybody. Let's go. So, let's get into it. I'm looking at ADA. We'll do it here. I have a question. This is going to be a Q&A thing. I have a question to answer from a member, and I'm going to do it on this ADA Cardano setup. Let me turn off a couple things that you guys don't need. Just kind of waking up and starting the day. So excuse me if I sound a little weird and I sound like moving stuff in the background. You know, it's a bit of a day. Got some things lined up. So there was a member named Basthy. I would open his profile right now, but I don't want to get into all of that extra Windows stuff. Let's just get directly into this. He's got a question. He noticed that in my RSI formula, right? I'm sorry. If you hear music in the background, it's this. It's a radio station that I own and plays music 24/7. So I usually have it playing all the time in the car. No commercials, no ads, easy on the phone, works on everybody's phone. Everybody around the world can listen to this with no complication. So go in there, go ahead, hit up antifmradio.com, go ahead, join the website if you want to, and listen to music 24/7, this kind of music right here. So let's get into it, Basthy. He had a question because I was talking about only the 50 level crossover in the oscillator, right? His question is basically, how do you go long below the 50 if your cross takes below the 50? How do you go short if your cross takes place above the 50? Well, I need to inform you something, Basthy, and everyone else. The RSI formula only works when you are crossing from the 50. That's it, okay? Any other time, you can use the oscillator, but you cannot use the RSI formula. So with that, the RSI formula goes bye-bye, right? You cannot use the RSI formula. However, the rules to enter are the same up until doing the calculation. So you cannot do the calculation. You cannot do that, right? So where was that entry that I was looking at? Here we go. Now, you can see that clearly we were in a downtrend, right? Here's the highs, here's the highs, here's the highs. You can see that clearly we were in a downtrend. And this is most likely price was overbought. Yep, look at that. Heiken and Eshi candles are not touching the RSI. I want you to pay close attention to that phrase. Heiken and Eshi candles were not touching the RSI. When that happens, this is true overbought. Not because it's in this area, not because it's in the area of the oscillator, only because the Heiken Eshi candles are opening and closing and they are not touching the RSI. That is overbought when they're above it. This is oversold when they're bearish and they're below it. This is oversold, okay? Now, this can happen anywhere in the chart. This happens here. See, this happens here, but it's not in this quote-unquote what people keep saying is the overbought or oversold area. This does not mean overbought, oversold. This does not mean oversold, all this. Because you can see here, this, they're touching. Heiken Eshi candles are touching the RSI. Now, let's get into, away from that, and let's get into what we're talking about here. So, the question is, how do I go long if I am below the 50 and I want to go long? You need to know that at that point, you are not necessarily going long. You are, however, doing a long scalp. So with that, I highly suggest, this is my Mass Effect moving average, don't worry about it. I highly suggest you put on at least two exponential moving averages on your screen. You need a 50 and a 200, okay? And I have here a 50 and a 200, okay? And there's a reason I keep those. You can also see that my 50 is yellow, just like my midline, and my 200 is red, just like this area, okay? Now, the rules for entry, going long below the 50. Again, I am not going to use the RSI formula. You cannot do that. You simply use something else. So here you have here's the rules for entry. At one point, your, what do you call it? At one point, your moving average must be below the 40, okay, that 40 level. Your moving average must have crossed below the 40 along with your RSI. Right here, if you look real close, it looks like it didn't. But if you look at the readings, the moving average is actually 39.76. That's less than 40, which means here it was below 40. Why is this considered an entry candle when clearly it's not breaking above the 50? Because you don't need to. You're trying to scalp right now, right? So this is scalping an uptrend. What you are seeing is the end of a ranging market, right? Where the RSI has trouble breaking through this low part of the range, right? This is the upper part of the range, lower part of the range, the whole range, okay? The whole range, like that. That's the whole range. When RSI or high Ganashi cannot break outside the 60 or below the 40, then you are in a range. And that's how this calculation for these range signals, that's how that's showing up. It's telling you, bang, it's having trouble getting over the 50. Bang, it's having trouble getting below the 40. You're hitting a range. You're hitting a range over and over again. Now, entry. For the long position below the 50, your Heiken Ashi candle has to start below the moving average and below the 40, below the 40 level, and it has to cross both. Okay, majority of the candle has to be across both. However, the majority of the candle cannot be across the RSI. That means too much volume and not enough momentum. The RSI is momentum. The candles are showing you basic volume in that moment, okay? And this is breaking away. This is a clear rejection off of that 40 level of the range, or the low part of the range. So let me reiterate. Heiken Ashi candle opens below the 40 and below the moving average and below the RSI. It crosses the 40 and the moving average, but doesn't fully cross the RSI. This is your entry, okay? So you go into a long position at the close of that candle, right there. Your swing low is the last place that it dipped down, that the RSI dipped down. I don't like using one this close. It's too close. You see it dips down. I want another one with a wick sticking out the bottom or an actual low. Here's a nice dip down. I'm gonna take this as my swing low, okay? I can take this one, or I can take this one, either one. Here a pivot shows up, but you wouldn't have seen that pivot yet. I'm taking that long wick as my swing low. Now, you're entering here and you are banking on the RSI to make its way back to the 50. That's what you're doing. You're trading to the next line of influence against price, okay? If you look at your RSI, it made it to the 50 and it kind of went flat. Like I have said in other videos, the 40, the 50, and the 60 are severe, severe resistance lines for your RSI. Okay, let me turn this music down a little bit. Right here. There. It's just for me. They're severe lines of influence against the RSI. You can see that it went flat here and it took a long move to get, you can see it took a long candle to get it out. You can see that it came back down to the 50, had trouble, bounced back up, okay? And that happens over and over again. Now, you entered here, you know the rules. How far do you go? Since you cannot use the RSI formula, I can't tell you to say, go 1 to 2, 1 to 0.5, 1 to 1.5, whatever. You can't do that, right? Now, usually you scalp to the 50 and you're done. That's it, you're scalping, right? But here, I want you to notice that the wick of this Heiken Ashi candle has also crossed the 50. So with that, in this moment, you can go to the next line of influence, which would be your 200. This is why I'm saying you need to have your 50 and your 200 on your chart. So most of the time you just scalp to the 50 and you get out and you wait for the next movement, okay? You wouldn't have scalped to the 200 until the moving average crossed your midline, which happens here. So you would have gone from here to your 200. This just gets you into the higher part of the range to your 50. But either way, this ends up getting you here, right? And follow this rule. The wick crossed the 50. So skip your 50 EMA and go to the next line of influence, which is your 200, okay? And if you'll notice, once you get out of that trade, what happens? Price goes bloop down, three consecutive candles pushing down. At that point, you never would have known that the 50 EMA starts sloping upwards. When you see that happening, you know that, hey, I can get into another trade here. There's another little bit of room that I can get. And if you want, you can try that. You can try looking left for your previous swing high, whatever you want, right? Here's your previous swing high way over here. And you could have left some profits on the table, right? And you would have traded from, where did we get in? We got in here, right? You traded to here. You got out here, okay? And then price went down. You left some profits on the table and you said, you know what? I'm gonna go to that previous swing high now. I'm gonna see what happens. And sure enough, that catches over here. There you go, the move's over, you just picked up 2%, okay? Now, scalping, you do one of two things. You look for your first line of influence, okay? If something has crossed that midline, look for the next line of influence. I'm sorry, here. You look for your next line of influence. Your moving averages will resist your price. It does it right here, okay? And if you leave profits on the table and you really think that the move is really carrying on, you see the moving average has really gone a good distance, okay, then you go to your next line of influence. The reason I say that this is a line of influence is because you looked left for the previous swing high before price dropped off. That's it. That's it. So that's how you catch a long from below the 50. How do you catch a short from above the 50? Okay, like I said, you need to have the, You need to have the RSI moving average and the RSI and Heiken Ashi to be opening and closing above the 60. So this would not have been an entry to go short because look at these candles, right? They're halfway across, which means the open is below, the close is above. The open is above, the close is below. Nothing is fully opening and closing. You need a bearish candle to fully open and then close above the 60 to start your downtrend. That doesn't happen until here. And this too is a really dangerous move because you can see that the RSI doesn't cross until here, which means the RSI and the moving average never made it above the 60. They didn't make it up there. You need the RSI and the moving average and the Heiken Ashi candles to be above the 60, opening and closing above the 60. Here too, Heiken Ashi candle opens and closes above the 60, but your moving average and your RSI are still down here below the 60. Here. Now your moving average is above the 60. You can get ready for a pullback if you got out of this long trade or whatever the case may be, right? Now, the oscillator is clearly telling you where you should look for these movements, right? It told you here, exit your long trade. If you see an exit long signal, that means price is gonna move down a little or a lot, it doesn't matter. But you're looking for your RSI moving average and the RSI to be above that 60. Exit long means that you were in a long trade and then it's going to be going down, but you need to have all of these things line up. Now here, RSI and moving average and your Heiken Ashis are clearly above your 60. You get a cross to the downside of your RSI, right? And what happens? You have your Heiken Ashi candle crosses the moving average, touches the RSI. Great. This is also an exit long position. Let's get into a position here. Why not? Let's get into a short position here because you exited your long position. You're out of a trade, okay? But you can see that this same candle, when it closes, you can get into another trade. With that, you enter on the next candle, go for your swing high, right? And what do you target? You are banking on it getting to the 50. So take this out of the way. You're banking on it getting to your 50. And does it get there? Yes, it gets there, way over here. And again, nothing touches your stop loss. Clearly doesn't even come back into your stop loss area. You just traded this range all the way to the downside. All you had to do was look for this, okay? You needed to look for this. RSI Moving Average Heiken Ashi, crossing down after being all three above the 60. Enter and go to your first line of influence, the 50. You don't want to try and beat that. Now, how do you catch the rest of the move going down? Well, look here. The RSI, the Heiken Ashi, and the moving average were above the 50. You can see that they bloop, 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 bloop. They cross a little bit, and then the Heiken Ashi crosses below the midline. You could extend this trade now, right? You're going to get out here. At this point, here. At this point, you could change your take profit or set a second take profit, right? You can simply move this part, right here. Move this part down to this area of your 200. Because now you're banking on it getting to the 200. And does it get there? Yes, it does. Done. That's it. And at that point, price moves around a little bit, probably ranges, doesn't really go up or down much. This is a horrible range over here. You can see what's happening. Look at what's happening. The RSI, Heiken Ashi, moving average, they're really having trouble breaking away from this low part of the range. I would stay away from all of this. I wouldn't touch it. Not at all. Okay? So I hope that answers your question. Any other questions, feel free. Go ahead and drop it in there. All right? Again, all three components, Heiken Ashi, RSI, RSI moving average, they have to be above the 60 and moving down if you are going for a short. All three components must be below this 40 and moving up. Target your midline, target your 50, because these lines are the important lines where price always gets stuck, okay? I'm looking at the 60, I'm looking at the 50 right there, and I'm looking at the 40. Look at the RSI, look at the Heiken Ashi, it comes down, it gets stuck, goes up to the 50, flatlines, goes down to the 40, gets stuck, goes up to the 50, flatlines. Long candle shows up here and you break the 40, right? Then it comes up and you have a small move to your 50 period moving average. You're kind of good right there, right? After the moving average crosses above the 40, okay? And that's end up right here and you get out right there. Well, you actually get out way over here, okay? So, as long as you follow the rules, you will not fail, okay? Have a good day, everybody. Enjoy the music. See you at the next round table in the coffee shop.